If I hit you with a yodel, it'll hit you right in the heart. I'm Gary McMahan. I've been yodeling a long time, and it all started with wanting to put some yodels in my songs because that was the tradition, you know, cowboy music had yodeling in it.
If these yodels don't light your fire, I'd like to respectfully suggest that perhaps you would as well.
Get around a campfire, you get all talked out after a while. And those that could sing probably did, and those that couldn't. It was just kind of, you know, their form of art, telling stories to poems and stuff like that.
More than just a thin line to the east is the steps in the coal rail and captures the beast. Cold saddle blankets, hey, cock-a-doodle-doo, don't buck now, you booger, you break me in two. Jokes and jabs, cow boss's orders, a chew and a toothpick, and you're out the door. To saddle a horse you use for the day, making sure your rigging's got no extra play, you steps aboard light with him all gathered up, because you know firsthand this critter can buck. Yeah.
Woo. A friend of mine said, hey, they're having a trail ride down on the Bell Ranch in Solano, New Mexico. It's a collection of cowboys and cowboy singers. All the cowboy arts are on display, including the cowboy philosophies. These cowboys, they look at you with this clear, level gaze, and they're not afraid of man, beast, or devil. Brice comes in, and he's supposed to be some kind of hotshot trick rope, and then starts doing all these rope tricks, and you could tell, whoa, this guy didn't know what he was doing. I mean, this was the real deal right here. We have admired each other for our own separate kind of cowboy art forms for a long time. There's no way I could ever do even a little bit of what he does. I'm telling you, he is the best trick roper I've ever seen in my life.
Well, the wind blew and the cow shit flew, and we didn't get back for a day or two.
Jeff, he has this quiet authority about him to where you won't find many guys that question him. He's what you'd think of if you ever thought of a cowboy. He plays guitar, he sings really good. He runs his own cattle. Everybody respects him.
Well, I had to catch a train up to Atlanta that next day.
I left one of the best poets that is out there. Please welcome Miss Yvonne Hollenbeck.
Thank you.
Yvonne, she started showing up a few of these cowboy poetry gatherings, and she's a good old gal from Nebraska, a good old rancher's wife, and her husband is a damn sure cowboy now.
Well, I went and got a halter and a bucket full of oats, and good old Reddy came up to me and nuzzled on my coat, just like so many times before. But this time was the end. The vet was here, and he was here to put down our old friend. Well, I learned just how tough I was. Guess I must have lied when I told myself it won't be bad. The bad part's how I cried. I could have filled a bucket with all the tears I shed. And I hope you never face a task like putting down old Red.
Yvonne is one of these gals that could probably do anything. You know, she can sort cattle, make a quilt, you name it. She's done it.
I just finished the quilt I made my husband. And it has a picture of him roping on his rope horse Fudge, because he won the U.S. Calf Roping Championship on that horse. But I love quilts and the history that's sewn into them. I've just always had a desire to make them.